basically, what are the features of a hydrate? We're just going to say it's an ionic compound, and we know how to identify those, and water. So right here we have a good example of an ionic hydrate. We have CuSO4, and then that little dot there means that those five water molecules are actually surrounding my ionic compound. What that really means is that I had my ionic compound and I decided to dunk it into water. Surrounding it are these five water molecules. Now, we're going to say the rules for naming the ionic part are the same rules we've been following. Now, we're going to say that the metal is written and named first. If it's a transition metal, remember, transition metals have more than one charge, so we have to use Roman numerals to describe the particular positive charge that we see. Now, if that ionic compound happens to have just a regular nonmetal, remember, that nonmetal keeps its base name and has its ending changed to IDE. And if that nonmetal portion happens to be a polyatomic ion, we name that polyatomic as we normally would. So the rules that we learned for ionic compounds stay the same. Now we have to introduce rules when it comes to the water portion. We're going to say that the water portion will be called a hydrate. And we're going to say to describe the number of water molecules around the ionic compound, we have to use these numerical prefixes that we have on our right. So mono, di, tri, tetra, penta, hexa, hepta, octa, nona, and deca. So this is the approach that we're going to take. Let's go back up to that first compound that we saw. So remember that copper is a transition metal. So there's a possibility of it having more than one charge. So remember, what do we do when that happens? All we do is we just say that this is X. Then we're going to say SO4 is a polyatomic ion. Remember, that is sulfate. Sulfate has a negative 2 charge. Okay. So you have X minus 2 equals 0. So X equals plus 2. So the number of that, the charge of that copper is plus 2. So its name would be copper 2 sulfate. That's how we name the ionic portion. Now we have to name the water portion. Now we say that there are five waters, so the numerical prefix would be penta. And the water portion we just say is called a hydrate. So the name of the structure would be copper 2 sulfate pentahydrate. So that's how we take the approach to naming ionic hydrates.